Assalamu alaikum students, this is lecture number 3 on the same chapter S2 linear combinations, okay, of random variables. Now we are discussing some 2021 past papers, topical past papers, and giving the concepts as well on that. So this is May, June, this is March 2021, paper 6, variant 2, okay, of 9709 A-level mathematics, linear combinations of random variables. And the reason I've chosen this question is basically a lot of similar type of questions you will find in 2020, 2023 papers, 2019 past papers. All of the recent papers are based on this type of part A and part B. So make sure follow the lecture till the end and understand, okay. So this chapter is S2, this question is S2 linear combinations of random variable, and the concept I'm discussing can be said that we are discussing the concept number 2, that is basically the independent observations from same distribution, okay. So this is basically the independent observation from the same distribution, okay. So what does it mean? This is a fancy word for it. What does it simply mean? I'm going to explain that. Independent observation from same distribution. And again, the same concepts, if you have followed the lecture number 1 and 2 carefully, you will be able to understand this very easily, okay. So let's read the question. It says basically that we have the volume in liters of juice in large and small bottles. So the large and small bottles are the independent observations. Okay, students, the large and the small bottles are the independent observations, sir. They have the distribution that is normal. N stands for normal. Normal distribution this and normal distribution this respectively, so they have the same distribution, okay. So that is what the concept is, two different things from the same distribution. So what do we have? We have the volume in liters of the juices. So we have the liters of juices volume in large and the small bottle, they have the distribution. So let's write this, okay, very clearly. So first thing will be the large follows, L stands for large, okay. Large follows a normal distribution with 5.10 mean. Make sure your S1 concepts are very crystal clear. 0.0102 is the variance. S stands for the small, and small follows also a normal distribution with mean as 2.51 and 0.0036. If any student is getting confused that, sir, why you have choose? So it's basically whatever is written first, that's for the large one, and whatever small, because small is written later, respectively word also suggests that, okay. The word respectively or simultaneously, these words also suggest this thing, students. So hope everyone got it, that we have the volume of juices in large and small bottles, they have this distribution. I've written down that large also follows N normal distribution and small also follows, these both are independent observations, and we from the same distribution, that is normal distribution. Moving forward, let's read the question. We have to find the probability that the total volume, very important, okay, we have to find the probability, that's the normal thing. Total volume of juice in 3 randomly chosen large bottles and 4 randomly chosen small bottles is less than 25.5. Okay, students. So everyone needs to understand this is basically called sum of independent observation. Okay, when you have this type of question that says that 3 randomly chosen large bottles or 4 randomly chosen small bottles, so this is going to be the sum of independent observation. This is not multiple observations. Okay, for multiple we are going to do the part B. This is always going to be the sum of independent observation. So what they are saying, basically they are saying that they need, simple in simple words, students, they need 3 large bottles, L1 plus L2 plus L3, and they need 4 small bottles, so S1 plus S2 plus S3 plus S4, okay. That's what they need, 4 small bottles and 3 large bottles, okay. So in simple words, we can write this down that this is sum of the independent observations, and here we go, it will be 3 large bottles plus 4 small bottles, okay. 3 large bottles, students, and 4 small bottles. So now when you get this derive, okay, understand that you'll have to make, find the mean and variance for this. So the mean for 3 large plus 4 small bottles, or you can write this in the better way, that is adding a summation of them, okay. So let's write them the same way, that you can say the mean of all this thing, let's call this basically T, okay. So this, let's call this T, okay. So the mean of T is going to be basically you multiply 3 times of you're going to multiply the 3 times of the large bottles mean, that is 3 times of 5.10 plus 4 times of the small bottles mean, that is 4 times of 2.51. okay, students, so here we go. When you have multiplied, let's see what the mean we are getting is 3 times 5.10 plus 4 times 2.51. so we got that as 25.34 as the mean, students. Okay, so this is the mean, okay, in simple terms. Then you are going to find the variance as well for this t. So understand, variance is not going to be square because this is sum of independent observation. This is not basically the multiple, okay? So if, when you have the sum of independent observations, you are only going to add the variance as well. So you are going to say that it will be 3 times of variance will be 0.0102 plus 4 times of that thing, that is 4 times of small bottles, that is 0.0036. so you'll get the variance as well, students. Let's do calculator here. 3 into 0.0102 plus 4 into you got 4 into 0.0036, and the answer we got is going to be 0.045. okay, so you're going to get 0.045. okay, hope everyone gets this. Okay, this is very important. 3 into 0.0102 plus 4 into the variance of the small bottles, okay, that is 0.045 is coming. Okay, hope everyone got this. That's the first main thing. That will give you 2 marks or 2 to 3 marks from this question of 5 marks of the past paper. And this is, as I mentioned, we are discussing the concept that sum of independent variables. I'm going to do a couple of more questions as well, students, so don't have to worry about that. So this is mean and variance, and now you can say that t follows, let's say, because we have derived from t, so t follows a normal distribution, that is mean, or let's write this in a black color only. So t follows a normal distribution, that is mean 25.34, comma the variance, that is 0.045. okay, hope everyone gets this. And now what you have to do, just have to find, choosing small bottles is less than 25.5 liters, so the probability of total of them should be, probability of t should be less than 25.5 liters, okay? 25.5 liters, it should be less than. So always remember my S1 concepts, that make a diagram, because now it's simple normal distribution solving, students. So here you go, sir. Main thing is, if you have to, the way you find the mean and variance, because this chapter is all about mean and variance. If you get the mean and variance correct, that's it, okay, students? So 25.34 will be here. So it's very simple, that 25.5 will be here somewhere forward, okay, students? So 25.5 will be here, and we need to find the less than value. So it's very simple now as well, that in order to find the less than value, it's going to be this thing. So 25.5 minus the, how do you get the z value? So let's work out the z value as well, students. That will be 25.5 from the S1 concept minus 25.34. Understand that you divide it by the standard deviation, because you have been given the variance here, so you will have to square root that, okay? So it will be, have to square root that, you will have to square root 0.045, and you will get the z value, okay? So let's see what the z value is getting. 25.5 minus 25.34 divided by a square root of 0.045. In the calculator, I'm getting 0.754 to 3 decimal places. You need to find the probability of z is less than 0.754, students. You go onto the table, the MF9 table, and here we go, sir. 0.7 is here, 5 is here, and 4 is here. So you add 0.0012 and 0.7734. Make sure with the calculator you do this, and you're going to get the answer, students, as 0.7746, which I'm going to round off, and I'm going to write down this as 0.775. So this is how you get the 5 marks, okay? 2 marks must be for the normal distribution, but 3 marks are for getting the mean and variance and carrying out this task. That is basically sum of independent observations. This is the same distribution, normal distribution with normal distribution. We might have 2 different distributions as well in this chapter, but this is the most common question that usually comes, okay, students? We'll do more questions on this similar type of concept. So make sure, follow very carefully and understand and practice this. It's going to come a 10 mark definitely question comes on the S2 linear combinations of random variable chapter.